So now we go to the independent sanity test. The independent sanity test is a statistical test used to determine whether there is a significant difference between the mean score of two independent groups, for example, control group and experimental group. In language teaching, this test can be used to compare the performance of two groups of students on a particular language skill or task. For example, when I give you an example that I use one kind of teaching method like task-based language teaching, for example, and then I train the student in the traditional classroom, and the same teaching method I train the student in the online platform, for example, Google Meet today we use. And when we have the post-test, we compare the post-test of the two group, control group and experimental group, with the alternative hypothesis that there is a statistical significant difference between the two groups. So the data from each group, like the post-test, must be normally distributed and have equal variances. So because the score, we score like our scale from 1 to 10, for example, so it is normally distributed. The null hypothesis for the test is that there is no significant difference between the means of the control group and the experimental group when they use task-based language teaching to train the student in the control group, traditional classroom, in the experimental group, the online platform like Google Meet today. While the alternative hypothesis is that there is a significant difference between the post-test of the two groups, the t-test produces a t-value when you run the test, and it has the t-value, which is calculated by dividing the difference between the means of the two groups by the standard error of the difference. The t-value is then compared to a critical value from a t-distribution table with the degrees of freedom equal to the sum of the sample sizes of the two groups, minus two, and the significance level set by the researcher. For example, if you have 30 students, and then it minus, like you still have about 28, so the t might be 28. Suppose the calculated t value is greater than the critical value. In that case, the null hypothesis is rejected, and it is concluded that there is a significant difference between the means of the two groups. On the other hand, if the calculated t value, or if you look at the significant two-tailed significant, it is less than the critical value, the null hypothesis cannot be rejected. And it is concluded that there is no significant difference between the means of the two groups. In this example, the score of the students compared from the control group and experimental group. The independent sanity test can be useful in language teaching research to compare the effectiveness of different teaching methods in case that one you use in the control group and one you use in the experimental group. The performance of the student from different language background, or the impact of various instructional interventions on language learning outcomes, you can use. So if there's no difference between the two groups, it means that the control group learning from the traditional classroom and the experimental group learning from the online platform, as I give an example, they have the same values of improvement but no difference. So it means that the platform, online platform, and the traditional classroom are similar values that affect on the student learning. So in that situation, the null hypothesis is not rejected. However, if the null hypothesis is rejected, mean that one group whose mean score is higher, is that group improve much more than the other group. Another example of applying independent sanity test in language teaching is the study by Lee and Chen 2016, which aimed to investigate the effectiveness of mobile-assisted language learning. on the English listening comprehension of Chinese university students. The researchers used an independent sample test to compare the listening comprehension scores of the experimental group who received instruction through mobile assisted language learning application and the control group who received traditional classroom instruction. The result of the t-test show that there is a significant difference between the means of the two groups, indicating that the mall approach, mobile assisted language learning, was more effective in improving student listening comprehension skills than the traditional instruction. So that is one example of the a research paper. But actually, when I do my research, I also use independent sample test. When I, for example, the paper published recently on collaborative writing, so one group, I help them to write individually. One group, experimental group, I help them to write collaboratively, share authors, and then after the training, I compare the post-test of the two groups. So I use the independent sample test. And then there is a significant difference between the two groups. Indicate that the null hypothesis is rejected because there's significant difference. And the result indicate that the student who write collaboratively improve their writing skill much more than the student who write individually in the control group. So those are the examples when we use the independent sample test. When I give you example, I just mentioned about we use independent sample test to compare the post test. But actually, before you run, you do the intervention treatment for the student, you also compare the pre-test to see if the student level at before the treatment are the same or different. And in that situation, you also use the independent sample test. Remember, when we compare two different groups, we use independent. But when we compare the same group, we learn later, we use the pair sample test. So at the beginning, when you learn SPSS statistics, pair, you often confused with the independent pair. You thought that pair mean the two group. No, two group mean independent, but pair one group. Okay, pair for one group. Okay, so I think now that's what I just mentioned about the independent sample test. Do you have any questions?